On board, you can see that. Prepare a temporary mount of leaf pill to show stomata. Okay, that is our activity. Temporary mount. What is a temporary mount? That will say tell you. You can also see that how we'll do that. Leaf. Okay, you know that in leaf, stomata is there, and both the surface. Both the surface stomata is there. And here is the structure of the stomata, that it is there in your book, NCERT book also. Okay. Now, we have to do that the practical, and under microscope how we can see this one. All right. So, the temporary mount the activity, now it will be shown. This is the stomatal pore. This is called stomatal pore. And these two are the guard cell. You can see that guard cell. In this guard cell, there are two different type of, wall. Here, this wall, which is yellowish in color, you can see that, which is thick wall of guard cell. And another part is the thin wall of guard cell. Why these are thick and thin? That is also will be told afterwards. Now, here the guard cell, now it is, when it is in bend in position, see that the bend and both the sides, so that the pore will open. And here in this cell, here is a chloroplast is there, the vacuole is there, big vacuole is there, like plant cell, it is there, only the difference here, the thick and thin wall in its anatomy. Now, outside this, some cells also there, many other cells also will be there, that is the epidermal cell, subsidiary cells, all these cells. Okay. So our main focus will be this, the guard cell and the stomata. Stomata may be open, may be closed. You know that when it is, this pore will be, this two wall will be attached, then it will be closed, and it will be detached. And when it will form that the curved structure, then here it is. The pore will open. When it is straight, then stomata will be closed. Now come here in the practical how we can do that. Okay, here we have taken one leaf. This leaf, it is there in school garden that I want to show you, that from where I have collected. You can see that this is the ornamental here in school garden. So from there we have collected any dicotyledons leaf, we can collect it. The leaf is having the two different clear surface. This is the dorsal side. You can see that this is the dorsal side. Dorsal side means that the main part where the sunlight will fall. Sunlight will fall, and this is the ventral side. This color is different. Now, here the difference in stomata also. It means that the stomata is available, that upper and the lower, both the surface. Okay. So, stomata is available, but there are the distribution is different. It means that the top level, which is called the dorsal side. The dorsal side, the number of the stomata is less in compared to the ventral side. I think you can understand that this is the area where the most number of the chlorophyll is there. And here in the lower portion, from the lower portion, that the water vapor will, transpiration will take place. So for that, the transpiration, that number of stomatal pore will be more here. Okay. Now, how we can do that? We have to take it out, this thin layer from here. For the taking out, no need of any instrument. By hand we can do it, and this is the best measure. So now I'm doing it. You just observe. See that this thin layer we have to collect. Okay. Now this thin layer, now we have to place it. Now I'm going to the next part of it. Here it is. And a very small part is required for microscopic study. Look at here. Now I think it is visible to you that you can see that one green part and another transparent part on slide. Transparent part, okay. Then I am cutting this part and I am separating from the green part. Okay. Look at here, this thin part, it is now on slide, it is. And here I gave a few drop of water to make it live. Now next part we're going to do, that is staining. Look at here, this is the staining material. This it is safranine. I think you can read from this, the safranine solution. This safranine solution, I think in class 9 also you have used it. Safranine solution, I am taking it, read in color. Okay, this is useful for the plant animal staining. What is the use of staining? I think now in class 10 everybody know. Then also I am telling you that staining we are doing because we can see it properly under microscope. Otherwise under microscope many things are transparent. Transparent which is not visible properly, that and all will be homogeneous type of same type of things. Okay, now in staining material when we give, after that we have to keep it for few minutes. Here few minutes means here we'll keep 1 minute. Because it is raw, it is 1 minute we have to keep it. And if we give that staining material, this staining it helps to make it clear, the prominent, especially here we are using the plant cell. The plant cell cell wall will be stained properly, and inside the nucleus, here it is guard cell, chloroplasted, all will be the prominent, but in radiant color. Here we have given another staining material we are using, the methylene blue. Methylene blue also can be used in this. But here in safranine that we have used, here one advantages, that is if it is overstained, then also the slide will not damage. Sometime it is overstained. If you keep it for a very long time, then it will be overstained, and under microscope all everything will be black. Now if 1 minute is over, I think so, 1 minute is over, now we have to wash it. Wash means here we have to drain the extra staining material, and we have to put here. Look at here, I am just with the help of brass, it is just ordinary. Okay, so here here it is, staining is completed. It means that the first is taking out, that if we take it first part, then staining is the second part, and third part is mounting. Mounting here, the temporary mounting, it is told temporary mounting. Okay, okay, temporary mounting means to fixing. Here, mounting means to place in the on the top. Mounting here, it is fixing something under microscope. It should be a fixed position to see it. You can see that this is cover glass. Cover glass here we use, and mounting media. Mounting media we are using glycerin. The why we are using glycerin? Because it is temporary mounting. One thing I just want to tell you that on board you have seen that temporary mount. Temporary, there are two type of mounting, temporary and the permanent. Temporary mounting means we after washing we can remove it and wash it and we will keep it. And again we can do it, if any mistake we can do it once again. But in permanent type of that, we are using some epoxy resin, the Kannada balsam, that kind of things. If we fix it once, then it will be forever. There are some permanent slide in our lab, all are permanent, mounting. Okay, so now we'll here the glycerol. So I'm taking the glycerin here. Here glycerin, okay, we have to take little bit more and after that look at how I am doing. I am just holding this cover slip in 45 degree angle here, and here it will be 45 degree angle. After that, and another hand part, I'm gradually okay. So this is mounted, and other part with the help of blotting paper it will be removed. Okay, so now it is fixed, now it is ready for watching under microscope. So under microscope you can see now. Can you see some structure which is very clear?
Yes, sir.
Just see the meat cells. Okay. So I'm making it. Please. Okay. All right. All right. You can see here. Here I focused one. You can see that the two veined bean like structure that which is. Side by side, and it is open state. Here it is open state, and that stromatal pore also we can see. You can see the subsidiary part also. It is in low power view, that is why very big. You cannot see. I think all you can see this two veined structures are there, that is stomata, okay, and some other subsidiary cells. Stomata, these areas anyhow the number is less. The distribution is not same always in every sides. No matter that, if we can see one then it is okay. So this practical you have to do inside the lab, when we'll get chance. But before that you just see that this type of structure you can see under microscope. Okay, all right. So everyone saw that. Can quit from this part. Okay. you just learned here the safranin, this name you write in your copy, S-A-F-R-A-N-I-N-E, safranin solution, that you have to write. With the glycerin you have mounted, the glycerin mounting, which is temporary mounting, that and other thing you have used, that the brass here, the cover sleeve, the blade to cut, and the watch glass, and the leaf. Leaf you write, no need to write the name of the leaf and the scientific name of the leaf, this is not required. You just write dicot leaf. So this is dicot leaf, every dicot leaf we are getting like this, and monocot leaf we know that the both the sides are same. Monocot leaf, this type of here you can see that this is the dorsal part, this is the ventral part. In monocot leaf both will be same, which is called dorsiventral leaf. Okay, so we are not doing monocot leaf, so just know that this is the difference. We are doing the dicot leaf. Okay, here is the practical. Actually main thing that you have to do, I think you can understand, the practical cannot be done at from home. Practical when school will open, then surely this practical will do. Before the another practical that was only for observation, but this practical is for doing. You have to do that. Okay, that you are still not understand. So there is a group and you can communicate with me. So thank you very much, those who have joined.